Good morning. Today we will learn about the autopsy report. The essential part of an autopsy report are preamble, body of the report, autopsy room photography or videography. Preamble. The introduction or preface of the report, which includes autopsy details like place, date and time of receipt of the body. Beginning of autopsy, autopsy number and name of institution where the autopsy are done. Details of deceased like age, sex, height, address and occupation. Details of investigating officer along with the inquest report. Details of the doctor conducting autopsy. Relative detail of the identification of the body. Now, body of the report. It gives the detailed description of all injuries, both external and internal, inflicted on the body. This part of the report forms the basis of opinion and subsequent cross-examination in the court. So, report should be as detailed as possible and carefully written. Again, I will repeat about the body of report. It gives the detailed description of all injuries, both external and internal, inflicted on the body. This part of the report forms the basis of opinion and subsequent cross-examination in the court. So, the report should be as detailed as possible and carefully written. Autopsy room photography or videography. It helps in preserve the finding about the body injuries. Other relative details after the body has been cremated. It is used as evidence in the court of law. Sequence of recording, that is video recording or photography. Bearing of the dead body like clothes, stain, cuts or hole. Front and back view of the dead body before and after wiping. External injuries recorded separately and serial numbered. Recording begins with the head, neck, trunk, upper and lower limbs. Actual dissection for exposing the body cavity. Suspected fracture site. These are the sequence of recording. Now, procedure of autopsy. First, external examination. The following steps should be taken. First, the identification of the body, that is, but in case of unknown body, where the name, address is of that person are not known, that is unknown body. In case of unknown body, records the general features describing height, weight, age. Age should be approximated, that is approx, not clear, but approx, sex, hair description, scars, tattoo marks and fingerprints are recorded. Condition of the body, whether it is stout, emaciated or decomposed. Clothes are examined for stain of blood, saliva, semen, vomit or fecal matter. Hair, cuts, burn or hole. Holes from the firearms. In case of cord or ligature around the neck, these are the external examination. Natural opening like nose, mouth, ear, urethra, anus or vagina are examined for the presence of any injuries or foreign body or discharge, that is pus or blood. Hands, a scraping from under nail is taken. Any injuries or bone examination for the fracture or any lesions or injury. Now, internal examination. It is general rule to start dissection and examination of the body organ of the cavity mainly affected. Otherwise, normally first thorax and abdomens are opened. Head should not be opened until the blood has been drained out by the opening of the thorax. That is, in normal case, we will first open the chest, then abdomen, then head. By opening the first thorax and abdomen, the blood will drain out, so that when you open the skull or when you examine the brain, the actual color of brain will be preserved. And if there is any lesion or injuries or clots or hemorrhage, then there will be clearly seen. A spinal cord examination should be done last of all only if there is any suspicion of injury to the vertebral column. Now, second autopsy. It is conducting an autopsy on the body on which an autopsy has already been done. It is common in Western countries. Its incidence is relatively uncommon in India because bodies are cremated except in case of few religions like Muslim or Christians. Aims and objective of second autopsy. To find the cause of death when it is not certain after the first postmortem. In case the relatives are not satisfied with the first postmortem report. Sometime the investigating police officer might want a second autopsy in the light of some new facts or development in the case. Procedure. It is usually done on the order of the magistrate or court of law. It is done by the board of doctors. If necessary, after exhumation, the body is brought to the place of second postmortem. That is, second autopsy is usually done by the order of magistrate or court of law. It is done by board of doctors. And if necessary, after exhumation, the body is brought to the place of second postmortem or mortuary room. A copy of the first postmortem report along with all other documents like photography, videography, toxicology report, if available, should be obtained before starting the second autopsy. If possible, the doctor who conducted the first autopsy should be present at the time of second autopsy. I will repeat again. A copy of the first postmortem report along with the all other documents like photography, videography, toxicological report, if available, should be obtained before starting the second autopsy. If possible, doctor who conducted the first autopsy should be present at the time of second autopsy. Now, negative autopsy. It is defined as an autopsy where even after complete toxicological, bacteriological, virological and all other investigation, no cause of death can be found. Failure rate is less than 5%. I will repeat again. Negative autopsy. It is defined as an autopsy where even after complete toxicological, bacteriological, virological and all other investigation, no cause of death can be found. Failure rate is less than 5%. Such cases are usually the case of young ones less than 35 years. The most significant reason in case of infant is its sudden infant death syndrome. Possible common cause of negative autopsy. First, death from fright and shock. Second, slight blow on neck, precardiac reason, genital reason due to vagal innervation, fat or air embolism, laryngeal spasm, sudden cardiac arrhythmia. Preservation of dead bodies. Natural preservatives. When a person dies in extremely cold climate, since the temperature is very low through the years, the body remains preserved for a year, even indefinitely. mummification or adiposor formation. Artificial preservatives are by freezing, temperature should be maintained at minus 20 degrees Celsius or by embalming. Artifacts. It is a change in the body after death which is likely to cause misinterpretation about the finding of an autopsy. These are abnormal findings introduced due to human, animal or environment action. It leads to wrong cause of death, wrong manner of death, under suspicion of criminal offense, delay in the investigation of the criminal death. Artifact introduced between death and autopsy. First, resuscitation artifact. Resuscitation artifact. Needle mark in front of the chest, arm, groin. Defibrillator marks on chest leading to electrocaution. Fracture of ribs during CPR. Damage to teeth and tongue due to laryngoscope. Animal bites. Embalming effects, hemorrhage. These are the artifacts introduced between death and autopsy. Artifact introduced during autopsy. Air in blood vessels, fracture in hyoid bones, damage to viscera, a skull fracture, faulty collection of blood from peritoneal cavity gets mixed up with gastric contents producing the high level of poison. Again, I will repeat. Artifact introduced during autopsy, that is the air in blood vessels, fracture of hyoid bone, damage to viscera, a skull fracture or faulty collection of blood from peritoneal cavity gets mixed up with gastric content producing high level of poison. Thank you.